I didn't kill nobody.
Sunday.
He asked me to be his spiritual advisor.
I'm looking death in the eyes.
As your friend, I want to help you die with dignity.
Dead man walking.
Sean Penn, Susan Sarandon, Dead Man Walking. 9 Sunday on City. Coming up at 12:25, Ron Howard stars in George Lucas's classic nostalgia movie about four teenagers and their last night in town before leaving for college. American Graffiti, it's the movie that inspired the long-running TV show Happy Days and all the other things that Tony Danza did after that. Gee, I thought it was inspired by pure greed. Well, maybe not. Richard Dreyfuss, Suzanne Somers, Harrison Ford, some people got their starts. Paul LaMatte, I could go on and on, but let's watch it.
Okay.
Star Trek TNG.
On Citytv. Weekdays at 11.
AM. Tell me again. Keep rolling. What?
Hey, what do you want to do for dinner?
Tonight, Long Way Down.
Tonight, may we? Tonight, Mellow Cello.
Good evening. Right out of a movie on the 401 at the Hogs Hollow Bridge in the evening rush, a loaded cube van goes out of control and airborne to the ground below. A heart-swallowing 180-foot drop to the snow-blanketed fairways of the Don Valley Golf Course below. OPP are not sure what started the incredible chain of events. Any witnesses should call Downsview at 235-4981. The van driver and a 9-year-old boy believed to be his son are both alive. Airlifted to Sunnybrook because access to the golf course was nearly impossible with the snow. The truckload of CDs also had a rough landing. Looks like the westbound truck might have run up a snowbank and right over the rail between the westbound and eastbound express lanes. Another daring gunpoint bank robbery in the western burbs tonight. Three men, two armed with handguns, did a supper hour takeover-style robbery in a busy TD Bank branch near the Aaron Mills Town Center.
We also believe at this time that a 1990 Dodge Spirit, four-door, red in color, bearing license plates ACFL571, may have been involved in this robbery. It had been stolen 1.5 hour prior to the robbery, and it has since been recovered in the Meadowvale area of Mississauga.
A couple of suspects wore masks, believed to be in their early 20s. Some similarities, but also some differences to the fatal bank robbery shooting in Brampton last Monday. Police not sure if there's a nexus or it's just a copycat job. And a moving funeral tribute in Brampton today for the slain TD Bank employee Nancy Kidd, shot in that armed holdup Monday by the elusive gang police have dubbed the Van Bandits. The 44-year-old Kidd's niece told numerous tearful stories in a eulogy. Nancy's husband David and children, Michael and Aaron, comforted by mourners, including the Brampton mayor, the police chief, MPP Tony Clement, and TD Bank Pres Charles Bailey. Police working some leads, but need more tips on their hotline at 905-453-3311, extension 7224. Got to find that stolen getaway car, the 92 blue Chrysler minivan. West Toronto traffic cops say this car pedestrian accident scene looked pretty serious on Brown's Line near Horner tonight. A man hit by a car after straying into traffic rushed to St. Mike's. Head injuries often look worse than they are, and that's the case tonight. Victim's going to be okay. Looks like he found himself in traffic's way after walking out of a local tavern. A meticulous search of collapsed rubble of that Beach's apartment building on fire has yielded some partial human remains tonight. The coroner's not sure of the ID or even the gender. Police have been looking for two missing tenants since Thursday morning, the 5-alarm fire, and neither Linda Elderkin or Paul Benson have turned up anywhere else. Searches will continue. A crane's being used to pull apart the mess, and the fire marshal is also looking for the point of origin and a cause. Surviving tenants couldn't save much of their personal belongings, and they're looking for new homes tonight. Big story that's still all around us tonight, the snow. Wish it would all disappear. Well, Mayor Mel says it's going to start going off our side streets first thing Sunday morning in the city center. Anita Rajpal has the scoop.
We've got victory over the storm. There's no two ways about it. We
Look, I didn't know if we could do it. I didn't know if we would. But we were lucky.
So the mayor says we've won the battle over the snow, but many of us are still having to shovel our way out of the streets. But come Sunday morning, we're going to get some extra help.
The plan is designed to clear those narrow residential streets that have been clogged with snow.
8 o'clock Sunday morning, side streets will see 20 extra crews working their way to remove the snow on the residential streets. A combination of blowers, front end loaders, and dump trucks will be used. Approximately 20 additional pieces of snow removal equipment supplied by the Canadian Forces will be available. Residents will be notified of the cleanup 4 hours in advance.
We will try to avoid having to remove vehicles to the extent possible, but that we may need to remove some vehicles through friendly towing. That would mean the tow would be at the city's charge.
Oh, so that would be good. But let's hope they do, because they promised so many things.
I like the idea that they're not tagging or ticketing cars.
So if you're looking for a place to park your car while your street is being cleared, the Toronto Parking Authority has extended its offer of free parking on its surface lots until the snow emergency has been declared over. From Wellesley and Young, I'm Anita Rajpal for City Pulse tonight.
With all those streets to worry about, it's easy to lose sight of the snow's punishing impact on the individuals who live on them. Videographer Beatrice Stuckey looked into that tonight and joins us live from one Midtown neighborhood. Beatrice?
Hi, Mark. I'm just on Yonge Street, right up from the Chum City building. And as you can see, Yonge Street is free and clear. The sidewalks are clear. The problem lies in the residential streets like Balmoral. And I focused that tonight. That's where I focused tonight to find out how the streets are affecting the real people.
There's no way! Get in there!
I guess you're pretty upset with this whole thing?
Well, we just let three cars pass, so, yeah.
What's your suggestion? What do you think they should do in this street?
In this street? They should get those tanks they brought down. Just take them all out.
Where would you put the snow?
The snow? I guess in the lake.
About 60,000 tons of snow have already been plowed from the streets of Toronto. But on many residential streets, like here on Balmoral, the snow just keeps piling up. So I went to ask the residents what they think should be done about all this snow.
They send a snow plow along. It doesn't remove any of the snow, and all you have to do is shovel out your driveway again. But if they would send the melter, it would just get rid of it.
They should make the street one way.
That would solve the problem?
Temporarily during the snowfall.
At least temporarily during the snowfall.
I think they should have huge heaters and just come by and melt it.
Well, there's a good idea.
Thank you.
And how do you...
Not all looks, you know.
People use the street as a throughway. And it's one lane, and it's very difficult. And it's been really hard.
This street has a... bad record for being plowed. I think we were voted the worst street in Toronto a few days ago.
Well, the residents are coping as best they can, and they're hoping that with the warmer weather coming up this weekend, the snow might melt a little, but otherwise the only solution will be this. I'm Beatrice Stuckey, live on Yonge Street. Now back to you, Mark.
All right, thanks, Beatrice. To get up any and every street in town tonight, the Canadian Forces have booted up their big bisons. These eight-wheel drive personnel carriers can go where fire trucks and ambulances don't have a hope. This one helps save a young woman suffering from smoke inhalation.
They're doing a great job. The Bisons today got out 18 people. They helped 18 people, took four people to the hospital. And the ambulances couldn't have gotten in. There's no way. They go in with paramedics.
And never one to miss a photo op, Mayor Mel made like General Patton in one of the big machines up at the Townsview Air Base.
Okay, move down, please. Move all the way down. All the way down, please.
These folks likely wishing for a bit of all-terrain action tonight. The subway's closed in spots for those lined up at Yonge and Bloor this rush hour. That just meant a long, cold, frustrating wait again for a bus to bridge the gap to stations uptown.
I wait for half an hour there, then I wait 1 hour over here.
Are you mad?
Oh, yes, of course.
It's pretty pathetic. TTC is really... let us down. I think it's really fallen in terms of the expectations we have of what I expect from a transit system in the city.
You'd think that they'd be a little more organized than they are, but do what you can.
The TTC's trying, but it won't promise things will be back to normal tomorrow. They tell us tonight it could take till the middle of next week before everything's running smoothly. Right now, shuttle buses are taking the place of the Red Rocket between Bloor and Eglinton on the Young Line, east of Woodbine, including the RT line, and between Islington and Kipling on the Bloor-Danforth line, and from St. Clair West to Downsview on the Spadina line. Taking the storm in stride out of Union Station tonight, GO train riders shunted onto buses kept their cool. All GO trains are canceled for the weekend. The whole system's being shut down so crews can clear snow and prepare for Monday's rush hour. Dial 869-3200 to get the GO Transit info line for updates on bus schedules. Time to talk danger tonight as people struggle to protect their property from the wrath of snow. You may think that you should head up and clear off your roof, but as Cynthia Mulligan says, in this very revealing piece of video shows us, that's one job you've got to leave to the pros. Watch this.
Ay, ay, ay. Oh, my God.
That frightening shot was taken by a professional roofer who was up on a roof with my Hi8 camera. Now, he's okay. He managed to stop in time. But one of our Much Music videographers did not. He's here at St. Michael's Hospital after falling off a roof this morning.
I've got a bit of a leaky roof problem and basically fell with some ice about 24, 25 feet down. And they're telling me I've got a busted back.
How bad?
They used the word crushed lower lumbar bits with lots of numerical numbers, so I ain't no doctor, but that sounds kind of nasty to me.
Lot of snow up there?
Yeah.
My guess is that we're getting in excess of 1,000 calls a day. It's called ice backup, and what's happening is you've got all this snow up on the roof, and you've got warm heat coming from inside the house, and it's melting the underside of that snow. So it's backing up and it's going inside the house.
So you think it's a buildup of snow on your roof?
I guess so, but I'm not going to go up there. It's just too dangerous.
The only thing you can do, Cynthia, is just get the snow and ice off the roof.
Hire someone to clean off the snow from the top of your roof.
Don't do it yourself.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
What's the cost of getting your roof cleaned? Well, some estimates go a little over $100 an hour. But think about it. It's better than ending up here. Cynthia Mulligan, City Pulse Tonight.
The emergency appeal for blood tonight as stocks continue to be dangerously low. The Toronto Blood Center has only a 24-hour supply, way less than they feel comfortable with. 974-9900 is the local number to call for a weekend clinic near you. The center's asking you to extend an arm and pump up the volume. And though there was a lot of stuff shut down today, most everything will be up and running tomorrow. All Toronto and Mississauga facilities will be open, including arenas, community centers, and museums. Shopping malls, movie theaters, and other entertainment facilities should have the doors open. It's always best to call ahead just to make sure, though, and take this number down, 599-7575. That's our City Pulse City phone. It'll give you an up-to-date list of closings and other storm information. Of course, all the recent closings are costing some merchants big time. Libby will focus on that angle and more coming up just a few moments in City Biz.
The Senate will convene as a court of impeachment.
Topping your World Watch tonight, day two of Bill Clinton's impeachment trial. Republican congressmen acting as prosecutors continued making their case to the jury of senators, but the U.S. president had his defenders.
Even if these facts were to be as alleged by Mr. Starr and the House Judiciary Committee, they would not rise to the level that was thought to be the standard by our founding fathers. We're talking about removing a president from office. We're about talking about overturning a national election.
As for Clinton, he carried on business as usual, attending a couple of functions in Washington and New York. An even more unusual trial in a Tennessee courtroom. Herbert Counsel tried to explain how he came to be driving a car when he is legally blind. He was nabbed by the cops after smashing a friend's BMW into a tree. He took the wheel, claiming his buddy was too drunk to drive. Counsel and his pal were both fined $500 for driving under the influence. And driving's still a bit of an adventure because of the weather, but things could be changing. Here's Harold.
Mark, we have a new problem tomorrow, a new system coming in from the west bringing 5 centimeters of wet snow
along with some freezing rain and ice pellets. Now let's check sports. Here's Catherine.
Thanks, Harold. Tonight we've got that new-look St. Mike's team from the Gardens, a little NHL water polo, and some poetic verse from Mike Tyson. But for now, let's see what's coming up in entertainment with Glenn.
Thank you very much, Catherine. Coming up in entertainment, Grammy Award winner Bob Carlisle blows butterfly kisses in Markham, and Yo-Yo Ma also on stage, but right now, it's back to Mark.
All right, thanks, Glenn. Ahead on City Biz with Libby, the markets in Toronto and New York take a big bounce up today. That much more after the break.